the whole field of peace building is focused on structural prevention, but there's very little emphasis comparatively to the lack of mechanisms that are typically in a society to deal with acute tension that can result in violence. This organization, Foundation for Coexistence, started a conflict early warning and early response program. The work that they were doing involved the use of events data, in other words, categorizing events into different areas of cooperation and conflict, keeping track of that over time, and looking for trends. In 2008, there were elections in Kenya that were very troubling to certain groups. There were a group of journalists who identified their desire to keep track of what was going on in the post-election violence there. They created a digital mapping platform called Ushahidi, in which events could be placed onto the digital map and you could keep track of what was happening in different locations. And over time, you can look at trends and you can identify hot spots of where there are concentrations of tension or even violence. We're still at the very beginning of understanding how to use this kind of technology for violence prevention, but the idea of being able to visually view kind of the lay of the land using social media like Twitter, Facebook, sending in SMS text messages, all of those are ways to collect events. They call it crowdsourcing, getting information from the crowd and posting those onto a digital map, tracking trends, identifying hot spots, focusing efforts where there are hot spots so that you can optimize your resources, training civil society organizations in those locations, building connections horizontally and vertically, and being ready if things start to deteriorate. I don't think there's any denying that the communication capacity is vastly improved, that the detection of incipient violence can be improved upon so that we know about it earlier rather than having to wait to hear rumors that it's about ready to occur. People are using something called data mining to identify certain signals in what's called big data out on the internet. You can see spikes in certain kinds of communication by using data mining. And as a result, you can start seeing indications, what are called signals, of possible violence before you normally would have been able to detect it.